Hello, in today's video we are going to look at track changes and comments. So you wrote a document in Microsoft Word and you want your colleagues to proofread it. You want all changes marked in red and add comments. In Word you can do this by using a feature called track changes and comments. Let me turn on track changes and show you what I mean. To turn on track changes you go to the review tab, you go to the tracking. And over here you will find track changes. When you tick it, it's on. When I turn track changes on and I change text, deletions get marked with a strike through and added text is marked with an underline. When I turn the track changes off, Word stops marking changes, but the colored underlines and strike throughs from your changes remain in the document until they're either accepted or rejected. Well, let's make some changes. Okay, select the name. Let's make it a bit bigger. My name is Rob and recipient name is Hans and the company is no idea. This word we are going to change in a different font and this one two. So now we have made some changes. Let me make some more changes and I'll be right back. So I'm back, I made some more changes. And the thing is you can add comments too. When you select a bit of text and you say right mouse button, you can add a comment. And I can say comments, I don't know what else to write. Using track changes, let the owner of the document see what and where the changes have been made, by whom, and lets the owner decide to accept or reject those changes. Of course, you can lose oversight of all these changes quite quickly, especially in a larger document with multiple authors. You need a way to look at the document. So, how do you want to see the document? When you go back up here, you can see all markups, a simple markup, a no markup, which is very difficult to check changes, or the original with no changes. So let me put all markups. Then there is another way how to show the markups is what to show in the markups. Show the markups by insertion and deletion, formatting and balloons. When you go to the balloons you see over here, show all revisions in line. That's what you see over here. When you want to see it in balloons, you get a bigger list with all the changes and multiple offers. Offer 1 has red, that's this one. Offer 2 is purple and it turns into a longer list. So you can also say I want to only see formatting or I want to see just the insertions and deletions. There's another thing you can do is when you turn them both on is say I just want to see one of the offers like all reviewers or just say well just this one and then you see just what I did under this purple account. Let me turn that on, all reviewers, and there is another thing you can do and is go to the review pane. You have a horizontal which I don't think is very useful, but there is a vertical one as well. So if you have a bigger monitor, you can see what has happened. I see 14 revisions and a more detailed list of what has happened. When you want to print this document, you can go to File, Print, and now you see all these markups. And maybe you don't want to print it with all the markups. Well, you go to print all pages, print markup, and when you decheck it, it's gone, or you put it back and then it's back. So now you want to process all these markups, and there are multiple ways. You can either say, well, I want to, for a specific person, I want to just do this one. And I can say, well, accept all, accept and move to next, accept all changes shown. Accept all changes, including the ones that are not shown. Accept all changes and stop tracking. Same goes for the reject. You can go, let's say, to this one, track previous, and now I see on a, when I put my mouse on it, hover inserted person. Right mouse button, do I want to accept it or reject it? I want to accept it. So now it's accepted. And I deleted team and I want to accept it too. So this way you can go via per reviewer, per line, per change, like this one. Do I want to accept the insertion? Yes. I have a comment over here. Do I want to, do I want to reply to it? Do I want to resolve it, delete it? Well, let's delete it and it's gone. So that's how you work with changes and comments in a document. And that's the video for today. Please help me out with a like, subscribe and share. And that's it for today. Thank you for your time. Bye bye.